TikTok.
Sounds like something silly. No one would believe that, would they, Mathew Dickerson?
No one at all.
Facebook has unveiled Ray-Ban, the sunglasses that I can't afford, that can have microphones, speakers and cameras in them.
I know, and I'm actually surprised they're doing it. It's the old saying, Richard, that any fool can learn from their own mistakes. Someone smart learns from the mistakes of others. And we've seen a couple of other companies have a crack at this sort of area. Google, Weber.
I saw it on science fiction. I saw it on Star Trek. I saw it on Lost in Space years ago.
You think they would have learned from that, wouldn't you?
Smart had it too.
That's right. Well, Google had a crack back in 2014, and it didn't go very well. People didn't like the idea of someone walking around with glasses, and they tried a bit of augmented reality as well as having a camera in the glasses. And there was one particular bar in San Francisco that was famous around the world for banning people in their bar with those glasses, and they came up with a term for someone wearing these. A glass hole was what they called them. A glass hole was what they had the term for them. So then Snap had a go at putting some glasses out with cameras in them. That didn't go very well. Now Facebook's decided that they've got some glasses, two cameras, three microphones, a couple of little speakers in them.
This is on a pair of glasses.
You plug them into your phone, and then effectively you and I could be sitting there having a coffee one morning, and our whole conversation, Richard, tomorrow morning on Facebook, there we go, and Richard's saying, well, hold on, I didn't see anyone filming what I was saying. I didn't see anyone talking about that. What's going on there? Because my glasses would be recording what was going on. Now, that's the biggest issue here, I think, the privacy aspect of it.
Absolutely.
And the extreme...
What about copyright?
All of that. And when someone pulls out a phone and starts filming, it's pretty obvious that they're filming. So, sure, people could say, I didn't know someone was filming me, but there's a person standing there with a phone in your face, and you can say, go away, I don't want you to film me at the moment, or yes, I'm happy to be filmed. But when you're just sitting there and you see someone with a pair of glasses, you don't think much of it. They're a pair of Ray-Bans. They look like a normal pair of Ray-Bans. They have said, because of the privacy concerns, believe it or not, they didn't have this in the beginning, but they've added this on. Because of the privacy concerns, we'll put a little LED light on the front so it'll flash when it's recording. But gee, you're going to have to be looking pretty closely at it to see that there's a little tiny flashing LED on the front of it to see it. So I don't think this will go very well, to be honest, Richard. I think it's another one that we'll put in the category of the Google glasses and the Snap glasses.
But see, they're Ray-Ban, so they're bound to, what is that, $500 or something?
I haven't actually found a price for them yet. They've only just announced them. I'm not sure you can actually go out and buy it yet, but I can't imagine they'll be cheap. A pair of Ray-Bans without video cameras, without microphones in them are expensive enough. So add those bits of technology, and I can't see them being that cheap. Of course, you've got to have a Facebook account to use them. You've got to have a Facebook account to be able to upload all this to it. And it's a bit of an indication, Richard, of the extreme laziness that we've got in society when it's too much trouble to put my hand in my pocket and pull my phone out. I'll just film by tapping the side of my glasses. Or I can say, hey, Facebook, start filming, and it will start filming what's actually happening.
So you turn it on. But wouldn't you see it if you were sitting in front of someone with these whopping great goggles on? Wouldn't you see it, or you wouldn't know?
Well, they don't look like whopping great goggles. They look like, as I say, a fairly normal sort of pair of Ray-Bans, and the cameras are just so tiny to build in. But think about the camera on the back of your phone. It's not very big. So you build that into the actual edge of the camera, and it's basically on the outsides of the glasses there. So you don't really notice it, especially if you were standing, say, 2 or 3 metres away. If you were right in someone's face, you might notice there's a little camera there, but it doesn't have to be very far away from you to actually say it's just someone sitting there with glasses. Or imagine if there was a group of people, there was, say, 4 or 5 people sitting around, you wouldn't really take much notice. I don't go and stare at someone's face and go, let me have a look at those glasses you're wearing, Richard, and see exactly what's in them. So you're just sitting around having a conversation. Next thing you know, you're looking at this whole conversation on Facebook. So I think that's the issue. I think that's where we'll see the problem, is that the privacy concerns, and Facebook, let's face it, Facebook does not have a great reputation, A, looking after our data, B, respecting our privacy. So when you combine that with an invitation to basically contravene someone's privacy, then you start to get to the area that I think is just a crazy idea by Facebook. But anyway, it's got you and I talking about Facebook, so maybe that's part of the process.
We're giving Ray-Ban a plug without getting any freebies. But Mathew Dickerson, the thing is that if this could be useful, couldn't it, in crime, to detect someone?
Yeah, so you've got some people now, like security guards, and obviously we see it on TV all the time where police have a camera on them, but they've got to identify that. So if a policeman comes up to you and starts talking to you, then they'll identify that this may be recorded, and they've got a camera that's in a pretty obvious location on their chest. You can see it's a camera, you can see it's something different. Same with security guards. You can see, typically they put a GoPro or something similar on their chest. So it's a bit obvious. You go, hold on, that doesn't look like something normal on your chest. It's a bit bigger, it's a bit more obvious, and they identify that. But this is the problem with these. It could be useful. I can see examples where it could be useful, but I just get the feeling that humans being humans, Richard, are going to abuse this usefulness potential.
Okay, now if you record stuff, where do you replay it? Is it on the glasses again?
No. It goes straight to your phone. So you have your phone nearby, it goes straight to your phone, and then obviously the idea for some strange reason is that Facebook wants you to upload it to Facebook, and so then the information's there. And then away it goes.
Zuckerberg earns another buck.
That's right. And it's all about just keeping people using Facebook and giving them some advantage over all the other social media sites that are coming out to compete against Facebook, trying to make it one step ahead. But I think they're better.
How far is all this going to go, this intrusion onto privacy, man?
And that's the question, isn't it? When you start to get to the stage when you're just sitting around, when we can finally get to pubs and clubs and cafes again, and the next thing you know, you're looking at what you've done the day before from someone else's perspective, you just go, gee, I don't really think that that's the idea to be able to broadcast all of my day-to-day activities. So look, again, it's part of that whole thing that Facebook wants you to do that. Facebook doesn't want you to miss a moment. Make sure you've got their glasses there ready to...
What would give it away is if you bump into somebody and it's 10 o'clock at night and they've got these on. Hang on. You don't want you've got your sunglasses on at night. And I've never seen you with glasses before.
That's right. That might be a giveaway, sitting at the at a nightclub at 10 p.m.
Thank you, Matt. Matthew Dickerson.
Thanks, Richard.
It's Tech Talk.